bring us back. I'd like to bring us back to the civil war in Nigeria.
Okay.
Yes, we're not in wartime, but you remember why the war lasted for quite a long time. It lasted for quite a long time because we saw the Biafran people as part of us, and that we cannot apply all the weaponries of war against them because it will amount to killing ourselves. But at a point in time, when the war was continuously prolonged, our Lord came up with it, saying, look, you are fighting people, you are giving them food, you are giving them medicals, then you are going to strengthen them the more. So, whether we like it or not, call it banditry, call it insurgency, we must agree that we are more or less moving to a war situation in this country, especially in those territories. We can no longer call it a family affair any longer. Mm-hmm. We must rise up to the occasion and face, let's call it a spade, and not just a tool. Now it's time for us to apply what we should do. The cries are coming. The cry of a child in the midnight is not a sign of disturbance. It's a cry for attention. What Masari is saying now is to say that, and for instance, I read also in the papers just 2 days ago that the northern elders are also beginning to criticize the federal government. They are beginning to be disenchanted about how the country is managed, both security-wise, exactly. Everything. So it's no longer the South versus North or the North versus South. It's not about all of us. And we're almost getting, terrified by this situation. So at this point in time, we must, as a matter of fact, the federal government must wake up. There must also be power devolution, like he was also trying to say. Why the military remains in the ambit of the federal government to control, because it's a security matter. There are other information gathering systems that ought to take place, even to help the military in terms of community policing, in terms of information from the neighborhood, in terms of all of those ones. So all of these things must come to play. But I recognize that the places we are talking about is massive forests. And then they are inhabited by nobody.
Yeah, but in addition to that, the...